next to the lion, the eagle is the most admired creature in the animal kingdom. If the lion is the king of the jungle, then the eagle is the king of the heavens, or the king of the air. So one is the king of the jungle, the other one is the king of the heavens. And without doubt, the eagle is the most powerful creature in the air. The eagle has matchless vision. That is the first thing. The eagle has matchless vision. He is greatly admired for his vision. In fact, an eagle has an eyesight estimated to be 4 to 8 times better than the average human. He has the best vision of all living things. Do you know that? Of all of God's creation, the eagle has the best vision. He sees the clearest, the sharpest, the best. He can see things normal people cannot see. Proverbs 29 verse 18 tells us, where there is no vision, talk to me, the people perish. Where there's no vision, the people perish. If you have no vision of the future, you have no power for the present. If you have no vision for your life, your marriage, your home, your family, you have no vision for your cell group, you feel, well, things are still going to be the same, same old, same old. You have no vision for the church. You have no vision for the company. And you have no vision for your future. Then you're powerless to handle the situation that you have to grapple with on a daily basis right now. An eagle is able to spot a rabbit 3.2 kilometers away. 3.2 kilometers, he can see a rabbit. Now, if you swap your eye with the eagle's eye, that means you can see an ant crawling on the ground from 10 stories up on your HDB flat. I know some of you, if you look down, your eyesight is so bad, you can't even see your toes, right? You can see a tiny ant crawling from 10 stories up. Everything we see will be in brilliant technicolor. Eagles can spot animals even when they're in hiding. That means camouflage animals will be of no use, because he could accurately spot all the different color shades, and no animal can camouflage itself from the eagle. And they can even correct refraction error from the water. So when they are flying, they can see fish swimming in underwater, in the sea. They can see it clearly, and they have auto correction. They know exactly where the fish are. Now, their eyesight is so super perfect, they don't suffer from nearsightedness or longsightedness. They have perfect 20/20 eyesight, even better. You know, once the eagle focuses on something, he locks onto the target. He locks on it. Just like heat-seeking missiles, right? Lock onto it. He can maintain razor-sharp, super-accurate focus, and he swoops down at a speed of 330 kilometers an hour. Now, that is the speed of an F1 car. So when an eagle comes down, by the way, everything I'm talking about the eagle, I'm talking about you. Because that's how God wants us to be. Now, as far as an eagle is concerned, he can swoop down at the speed of an F1 car. Now, and he never loses focus when he's coming down. He's so strong. An eagle is able to lift up an entire deer and fly away with it. That is how powerful an eagle is. That's how strong his wings and his claws are. Eagles have this super amazing ability to soar. How high can they soar? More than 4,600 meters in the air. That means they could easily fly over Mount Kinabalu. They could easily fly over Mount Fuji. They could very easily fly over Yushan or Mount Jade in Taiwan. No problem for the eagle. No problem. They can fly higher than most commercial helicopters. And eagles are not afraid of the rainstorm. Most other birds will hide in the leaves, in the branches of the tree, but not the eagle. He doesn't escape the storm. When the eagle senses that a storm is coming, he will fly to a spot and just wait, and just wait. You see, and then he uses the wind of the storm to lift himself higher. In fact, you can say he challenges the storm. And that's how God wants you to be. No matter what the challenge is ahead of you, you challenge the challenge. You confront the challenge. Because you know why? Because you just read the scripture a moment ago. Your affliction is light. It's but only for a moment. And it's working for you, your eternal glory. Hallelujah. So in fact, the strong wind gives the eagle an opportunity to rest on the wind. So he could just glide. So eagles are not like sparrows and other birds that got to flap, 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 flap. The stronger the wind, the higher he could soar. You see, so when, you know, the eagle would just glide with the wind of the storm above the clouds. And he could easily do it because rain clouds are only 2,000 meters high. He could fly beyond 4.6 kilometers. He could go double the height. But he got to wait for the wind to come and catch the uplift and just glide. Just rest on the wind of the storm. You know what? He's resting on the wind. He's not panicking. He's not stressed out. You hardly see an eagle flapping frantically. Most of the time, they are just gliding. And this is how God wants you to win in the challenges of life, in the battles of life. We don't possess our promised land by flapping and working out our wings frantically, nervously, vigorously, or as cleverly as we can. No, 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 no. If you do that, then even the young man will falter and faint. If you do that, even the strong will become weak and become weary. We possess our destiny by resting in God, resting in Jesus. Jesus says, come to me, I give you rest. We rest in the promises of His Word. We allow the Holy Spirit to give us the anointing of wisdom, the anointing of power, to soar and glide higher and higher and soar in life. Whether it is in our business, whether is it in your career, whether is it serving the Lord in the ministry, as cell group leaders, or as full-time staff, we learn to work with God and rest on the wind of the Holy Spirit. We rest in God. Now, Jesus Himself says, it's the nature of life to be stormy. It's the nature of life. Listen, if you're not in a storm right now, I can tell you, right, I can prophesy a storm is coming up. It's the nature of life. We go through storm after storm in life, but it's all good. All of us may and will experience stormy time, but a storm doesn't have to tear us up. A storm is meant to carry us up. You see, so we allow the power of the Holy Spirit to lift us above all the troubles, above all the challenges. And we must be bold to challenge every storm. So you are an eagle Christian. You are to challenge the storm. No, run away from it. You know, I heard somebody say, turkeys will run and hide. Chickens will run and hide. Eagles get excited when the storm comes. So you decide today, do you want to be a turkey, a chicken, or an eagle?